two fake screenshots send the house into chaos. Now on Big Brother Cheesecake 4 Office Wars.
So say I'm in the middle of the road, not much to show, underachieving average Joe. But I'm a hell of a lover, a damn good brother, and I wear this heart on my sleeve. And I'm a damn hard working, one thing's for certain, I stand up for what I believe. That might not mean much to you, but it does to me.
Hello, I'm Andrew Shevsek-Moonves. Welcome to Big Brother Cheesecake 4 Office Wars. It's day 42 inside the Big Brother Cheesecake house, and this week Curtis is the head of household on a double eviction week. He nominated Brandon, CJ, Lindsay, and Megan for eviction, but yesterday, CJ won the Big Brother Deal or No Deal Topaz Power Veto competition, the first female in the history of Deal or No Deal to do it, and she must use it today to remove one of the four nominees from the chopping block. What will she do with it? We'll find out shortly. But first, yesterday, while I was filming the video for yesterday, which came late because I was at my mother's for the weekend, there were two screenshots that went around the house. They apparently originated from, they originated from Ashley. I'm going to get to more in a second. They originated from Ashley. Were sent to, I believe, Lindsay, and then she sent it to multiple people, who then came to me after there was a big sort of behind-the-scenes fight or discussion about it. In the screenshots were Brazil, Nick, and Ryan talking to some unknown person in blue. And luckily, the house guests, because Ashley really shouldn't have gotten involved in the game, but luckily the house guests figured out real quick that these were fake screenshots. And I'm not even going to read. I'll post them here. So here are the two screenshots. Okay. First of all, the sequence of events and the discussion don't even really make sense. It doesn't really implicate anybody negatively or that negatively. And it just... The story doesn't make any sense, but worse, what makes it fake, if you want to do a fake screenshot, learn from Chad season one, Julian season three, people who know what they're doing. Like, the font was so bad, and as Nick pointed out, the statements or the messages on the right, the blue, should have been indented or it should have been formatted to the left, not to the right. So there's these big gaps that I'll admit I didn't catch that one, but for me it was the font. I'm a stickler for font, and it annoys the living hell out of me when fonts change. So Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? They changed the font a long time ago, and it pissed me off. License plates. Before the whole blue Ontario license plate debacle, Ontario changed the license plate font when they were around CAS to a smaller font. Drove me mental. Street signs. When you have, you know how one street sign will be like this, and one street sign will be like this. This one will get vandalized, so they'll change it. But now the font in this one is different from the font in this one. Drives me mental. When subway stations get renovated and they change the font on the wall, Spadina Station Line 2 on the east side, the Spadina letters are closer together. Drives me nuts. What's another one? Another one with street signs. This isn't quite the same, but... in terms of doing it right. So we have Wednesday, 12:10 a.m. The correct, in an actual Facebook Messenger, it's Wednesday at 12:10 a.m. So you left out the at. There's an intersection that Brampton Transit serves, Signal Hill Avenue. No, sorry, it is Signal Hill Drive. So the sign says Signal Hill Drive, the big sign. And then the small sign says Signal Hill Avenue. I mean, are you kidding me? When the person was installing the Signal Hill Avenue sign, they didn't notice that it didn't match the Signal Hill Drive sign. It's Signal Hill Drive. And that happens all the time, where two street signs will not match and they'll show a different suffix. It drives me mental that you're getting paid to do this and you're doing it so wrong. Here's another one. Pearson Airport in Toronto has two terminals. Guess what the two numbers are of the terminals? 1 and 3. I mean, and these people still have a job in planning. I mean, and I get it. There used to be a Terminal 2 that closed in 2007. It was a very nice, modernist, 1960s-built terminal. I really miss it because it reminds me of so many American terminals. I like that sort of concrete slab modernist design. I know I'm weird. I think Terminal 3 and the new Terminal 1 are boring. They're just boring like any other city. Terminal 3, I think, is almost the same design as Boston's Logan Airport. It's boring. But, okay, you close Terminal 2. So you wait a couple years, and then you rename Terminal 3 Terminal 2. So you have a 1 and a 2. You seriously, 1 and 3? Or if the new terminal, instead of making it 1, which was the old Russian cosmonaut, in case the Russians invaded us, we all hide in that bunker, that big asbestos concrete block. I love that terminal. It was just so wacky. You retire 1 and 2, and you make the new terminal Terminal 4, so you just have a 3 and a 4. But really, it should have just been a 1 and a 2, not 1 and 3. I mean, people are coming from around the world to Toronto for some reason, and there's no Terminal 2. It could confuse them. Oh, gosh. And then, yeah, what do they even come for? The Pan Am Games, World Youth Day was the last thing. I mean, I forgot which Pope it was. Was it the one that quit or the one that fondled the choir? I forgot. But anyway, where was I? Oh, yeah, so the font was wrong. And so I noticed that right away. Yeah, so it was obviously fake, meant to cause drama. Now, a lot of the house guests were angry because it came from Ashley, and Ashley's not in the game anymore. And Ryan's like, Ashley's better at being in the mole now than she was when she was in the game. And so I asked Ashley point blank, did you make these or did you get it from somebody else? She told me, and I can say this because she's not in the house anymore, so you have no DRs anymore. She told me it came from somebody in the house. I'm not going to name who because I don't want to totally screw that person, but I think the house guests probably have an idea. But yeah, so it came from somebody in the house. And that's another thing. Why send it to Ashley and then have her send it to someone in the house? What's with the middleman? Just send them out yourself. Why did you need her for? Anyway, Ashley was bored, but she's bored because she's going through cheesecake withdrawals, natural when you're evicted, and she lives in Kingston, so there's nothing to do there but have Arby's. Anywho. Okay, yeah, so I don't really think anything came of it because it was fake, except that maybe Drew made the house guests kind of paranoid and mental for a little bit. Anyway, it's now time to get to the Topaz Power Veto Ceremony.
Hey everyone, it's me, CJ. I'm gonna get full custody of my son, Jensen, cause my ex-husband, Fuckface, took him to Trinity Bellwoods Park, which endangered his life. So I'm gonna get my son back. If it's the last thing I do, I'm gonna sue for full custody. Hey, Brenda, I really like the chocolate leaf bananas because bananas remind me of penis. I like penis, but my ex-husband, Fuckface, his penis was too small so he couldn't reach my clit. Anyway, I'm now going to make my famous... Oh, I won the Topaz Power Veto, we'll get to that in a minute, but I'm going to make my famous rum cake. You all know the rum cake is the best. So, first, you go to the Cheesecake Factory and you get their famous birthday cake celebration cheesecake. Now, before I get to this, Chantel, you'll notice the F button on your keyboard for fast forward. That's the button you want to push now. And it's probably getting a little worn out. Meanwhile, on the other hand, you have JoJo, who right now is probably doing something like this. Anyway, so celebration or birthday cake cheesecake is the official cheesecake of Big Brother Cheesecake 3, Under the Sea, and they were supposed to have their reunion this weekend, but they couldn't. It is really sad. So that's why you need to start here. So you take your birthday cake cheesecake, and you put it on the plate, and yeah. Oh, hey cat, you want some whip? I got some whipped cream for you. I got some whip for you. Which? Maureen and Rhonda, I hope you pay attention so you can make this for your kid. You just, it's so good. Let me say, drink some rum. So now what you do, if I hope you can see this, son of a bitch, is you gotta get it onto the cheesecake. What the fuck? Why is it so fucking difficult? Oh, there it is. Okay, so make sure you slide it up your rum cake with some fine Bacardi rum. Okay? That's good rum. I'm so excited right now. Isn't this exciting, everyone? And then, you're done! And it's time for you to enjoy your fucking rum cake. I'm CJ, I'm so excited! I can eat it all! Woo, CJ! Anyway, Lindsay, alcohol burns my eyes! Lindsay, why did I use the golden dumbass battery to save you? Actually, Lindsay, I don't need to hear from you. I already know what I'm going to do. I decided that really burns to use the Topaz Pyrovito on myself. It's not worth the risk! And I want to remind everyone, while the alcohol is fucking burning, we're entering the jury, 9-person on the jury, and the nine of us going to jury, we're going to make the solar system. I'm the sun. The sun, everything revolves around me. And you have Jupiter, which is Ryan, because he's the big one with the red dot, which is the vein that gets, when he gets angry, it pops. And then all the other planets go around. And the two Atticus that get evicted this week, they're going to be what's called space junk. You know, like the balloon that the little kids let go of and the balloons go up into the solar system? That's them. Anyway, this Topaz Pyrovito ceremony is adjourned.
Brandon, Lindsay, and or Megan. Who will be evicted in the double eviction? Watch tomorrow as the final three nominees play their case and we learn the rules of the next head of household competition. And Wednesday is the double eviction, where two house guests will be fired from Dunder Mifflin, evicted from the Big Brother Cheesecake 4 House, and lose their shot at the $400 Cheesecake Factory gift card. I'm Andrew Shevsek Moonves. Take care, and we leave you as we eavesdrop on house guests.